Hi guys, welcome to Code Artisan Lab. This is our sixth video for Django e-commerce website, and in this video we will create the category list page and brand list page, in which we will show the all categories and all brands with the images and title. Okay, so we will create these two views and layout, and we will extend our base layout we have which we have created in our fifth video. Okay, and we will use the admin panel to add the data. So we will do these things in this video. Okay, so let's do this. So what we will do here, I will open the views.py file first. I'll close on the right, and here I'll create category and I'll create brand. Okay, so first of all we will create the layout, then we will fetch the data from the database. Okay, we will use the model to fetch the data, but first of all we will create the layout. Okay, so here we have let's say all category. Okay, category list request return render request, and this will be our category list.html. okay, so this will be our category list.html. so I will copy the categories.php file in our main templates folder, paste it here, and rename this with html. Okay, and I'll open this in code. I'll remove this, and I'll also open the index.html file so that I can copy this content here. We don't need the static folder, actually we need this because we want to load the images, and we will so I will remove this. This is PHP code, and this will also. Okay, so we will set up this path also. When we come to this point, then we will set up this. Now we have a categories.html, so we have to bind this with the URL, this views with the URL. So I will copy this, and I will copy a category list. So this will be your category list, and in view I'll copy this and paste it here, and here I'll add category list. Okay, so we will create this brand after this category. So okay, we will create the brand later. Now we have created the layout for categories. I'll need to remove this for loop also. Yeah, so we are done. Actually we need to add the static method here, images 1.jpg. yeah, now we are done. We have also need to open the base.html, and we need to remove this link, and we will add category list. You can add this, it will take the from the root, and if you want to do this like with the help of URL, then you will define the category list. So now I'm using the name attribute here. So this name attribute is, we are using this name attribute from the URL. So this name is category list, we can use in the URL template tag. Okay, so let's refresh the page. Refresh this and go to the categories. So it is saying that category list not exist. Yeah, it is saying right, because we have not created the category list, and we also define in the so we are defining this. Now we have refreshed the page. Okay, So I have refreshed the page and it is loading all the content. So this is our category page. Now we want to show the data here. Okay, so I will fetch the data, categories data. In this video I will also fetch the data from the database. So let's fetch the data. I am in the admin panel. Now here I will choose the file sports, like this file, and I'll save. Okay, so this will save the file in the media folder at the root. So it is created the media folder. Okay, because we have not created the media folder at the root, because we have moved this media into the main static folder, but it is now created the media folder because of we have defined this media folder in our project level setting file. Okay, if you remember, I have told you that in our previous video I have defined the media path. Okay, so it is created a media folder. Now in the media folder I have created the cat images. This cat image is created because when we have created the model, we have defined that I want to upload the cat images, category images, in the cat folder, so that it has been so that Django created this cat images in the media folder. Okay, now we have to fetch the images from this media folder, from this cat images. Okay, so what we will do here, so I hope you are understanding all the things. If not, then please add in the comment section, and if you have not subscribed to the channel, then please subscribe and like this video please. Okay, so now I will go to the views, and here I will import the model from dot models import category, and here we will use data equal to category. So this data is variable. Okay, category dot objects dot all, and I will get this with order by ascending order, descending order of ID. Okay, and here I will pass the data with the help of this dictionary syntax. I am passing this data in the categories. Okay, so this will be our, so I will check if data. Okay, if data, here we will end if. Okay, so please practice this as much as you can. Okay, I am doing this, I am creating this video in 15 minutes, 20 minutes, or maybe half an hour, but you have to practice this until you do this your own self. Okay, for data, for cat in data. Okay, maybe for loop is new for you, so that you need, as much as you practice, you will learn lots of things in each of your single practice. Okay, each of your single session of practice, every time you learn something new. Okay, so please ready your base so that you can do anything. Okay, so data, and now what we will do here, I will fetch the cat dot, and here I will refer my model. So this will be title, this will be title. Okay, one thing more we need to, I am doing this in categories.html, but we don't have any categories.html. we have to do this in category list actually. So I will copy the code, paste it here, and I will remove the categories.html file. Now it's okay. Okay, and here I will define the link. We will define the link later. Okay, and in the alt tag, so alt tag is important, because if image is not found, then this alt tag will show. And in this we will define slash cat, we will define media slash, and what is the it is saying the image. So this is the image. It will automatically add the cat images slash image name in the after the media path. Okay, so let's go to the front end and refresh this. I don't have any. It is saying that I don't have any categories. So let's find this. I'm using data. Okay, so if data, let's remove this cat image, refresh this. So cat in data. Okay, so we have, what we are doing wrong here? Okay, so actually we are doing wrong here. We are doing this thing in the home, but we need to pass this in category so that it is running here. And I am assuming that it is not running because of if this is saying this way. Okay, so it is saying that media. So we need to check this path. Okay, so we have media cat images 5.jpg. Let's go to media and in cat images 5.jpg. So it is existing here. So okay, let's remove this. Okay, one thing. Okay. Actually, we have defined the media, but we need to define the, we need to concatenate this media in the URL also. So I will take help from the Django upload file. I will take help from the Google. Yeah. So I will take. Okay. So maybe internet is something slow, but I will take from the help from my other Django app. I will take from a movie review. Okay, I'll take from the movie review. Go to the main urls.py file. And here I need to define this. I will copy this code. I'm getting the setting and static setting. And I'll open the my urls.py file, app level url.py file, and import this. Okay, and now I will concatenate this setting in my with my URL. So here, okay, so I'm concat. If you want to add this if condition, then you can add. Else, we are adding this URL pattern with the media URL and media row, which we have defined in our settings file. Okay, so now let's go to the. It is opening the Google now, but I don't need this. Let's refresh this page. So now we have a image. Okay, so I forgot this step. Okay, so no problem. I will upload this all code on the GitHub. Okay, so you can download this code, github.com/codeartisanlab. Okay, I have given the link in the description. In every video I have given the link in the description, so you can download that. Okay, so we have created the category layout. We have fetched the data from the database. So now let's add one more category. Let's add we have sports. Now let's add office, and let's add some image. Save, refresh this page. So office is come before the sports because of the descending order. Okay, so we will create the brand. Similarly, we will create the brand, but here you have a task that create the brand page. Brand page is also the similar with similar with the categories, but the task is you need to create this brand on yourself. Okay, on yourself to create this brand page. Okay, so try to do more practice on practice, and so that you will become a you will become master in Django. Okay, I'm also learning, and I will also I'm also learning from this project with you. Okay. So if you have any query, then please add in the comment section, and please subscribe the channel and like this video, and I will hope you will enjoying this series. If you are not enjoying, if you have any issue or anything that you you feel that it is not working or it will be something missing, then please add in the comment section. I am not perfect, but I will try to do my best, and I am trying to do my best, and I will, if anything is wrong or anything is maybe anything need to modify, then I will do surely. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Please like this video, comment on this video, and share this video, and subscribe this channel. Thank you so much.